So we're turned into the electrical workshop, and what we're going to do is give this a good whack. We know it's fire resistive. We know it needs to be held in using metallic fixings from discussions in the classroom, because when it gets red hot, we don't want it to move. In other words, it could shatter. So that's why we're using metallic fixings on fire resistive cables. It happens to coincide with the rules for premature collapsing, but that's by default. But I want to show how mechanically strong or robust it is by actually giving it a bit of a whack with a hammer. So if we do an insulation resistance test on it like so. So if I put those on like there, and then I do an insulation resistance test, if you can see the instrument, you can see it's greater than the machine can read, and I can do it to earth as well. We've had that before. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to give it a few little whacks. You might find that I drop the sound off at this stage because obviously the mic's going to be here, but I'm going to give this a few little whacks. And now see, it isn't round, so we'll give it a little bit of a whack. Let's try the old insulation resistance test again. Greater than 999. Well, let's just confirm that by going between live conductors to earth. Let's just do that, to live conductors to earth. Let's get them together. I don't want any jiggery pokery. Ah, okay, we go again. It's a bit harder this time, I guess. If you look at that cable there. That's looking not round anymore. Do we agree, audience? Can we see that? Does that look round? Okay, so we give it a bit of a whack. Let's try the insulation resistance test again. We have greater than the machine can read. Let's go between the conductors to prove we're not doing anything again. A little jiggery pokery. There we go. Greater than the machine can read. I whack it again. That's got it. That was a spider. You wouldn't think it would still be with us. Let's have a look. Dead sure. Okay, we're at the stage now. We've got a dead short. Let's prove and see if we've got a short to earth as well. Actually, we haven't. Okay, that one's clear. And let's try this one here. Actually, it's only shorted out between the conductors. Obviously, at that stage, it has failed. If you just look at that, okay, can you see that? Okay, yeah, so you can look at that, how flat we had to get it in order for that cable to actually fail. And that's hitting it onto a metal surface with a blunt object in the form of a hammer. It's dead flat almost there, so we were at stage 3 or 4 of hitting it before we actually caused that to obviously break down as a cable itself. So not only is the cable fire resistive, we know the ends aren't. These tend to be attached to plastic emergency light fittings, plastic backed bells for alarm systems and brake glasses. So we know the cable itself is fire resistive and the actual pots that we put on aren't, but we also now know it's a highly robust cable, okay, if you hit it with a blunt object. So let's hit it with a non-blunt object in a different area. So an area that hasn't been hit, let's hit it with a non-blunt object. So if I was to hit it with a screwdriver and a hammer, you can see straight away and through there. So it's sharp objects. It won't be as strong mechanically, but certainly you can give it a good whack with a blunt object.